Okay. So, of course, the reason why we're here is because you're, I guess we would say, ex-gay. You used to be gay, and then you married someone who used to be a lesbian, and you have three children, and I guess the jury's out on them. Okay. And would you say it's just like any other marriage of 14 years? You never have sex?
Oh, funny. Ha, got that. I don't classify myself as ex-gay. You know, I'm a heterosexual guy who dealt with some homosexuality.
Okay, so the people who come here are people who are wanting to do what you did. They want to reform their life and lead a heterosexual life.
Mm-hmm. But I will be honest with you. The reality is a lot of people come here and go right back into whatever they came from. And we don't just deal
with them. Because they're gay.
I believe that it's sin.
Excuse me, but don't you have it, no pun intended, ass backwards?
Meaning?
I mean, meaning homosexuality is something that occurs in nature.
I was out bird watching, but I'd rather watch you.
Why don't you come over and get some?
Man is who wrote the Bible. Nature made gay people.
Nobody's born gay. There's no scientific
rule. Really? Form. Have you ever met Little Richard?
But you know what? We can look at creation and say, what's the normal order? A man has a penis, a woman has a vagina. Let's just be blunt.
There's no scientific data that proves that anyone is born. There's no gay gene.
And you also discovered the gay gene?
Yes.
This is all coming from the Bible.
Right.
Which you believe to be the Word of God.
I do.
All of the prescriptions against homosexuality come from the Old Testament. Jesus never said a word about homosexuality. And if it's so important, why didn't he ever bring it up?
We could pick lots of little things that he didn't specifically talk about.
But this is a big thing.
Let me stop this whole thing. You know, I'm not sure what your documentary is about, but if it's to basically refute the Word of God, then I'm not interested in doing your interview, okay?
Well,
I think that obviously you don't have the same relationship with the Jesus Christ that I do.
But what is your explanation for the millions and millions of people around the world who are leading homosexual lives, have no interest in anyone of the opposite sex? Are they all faking just to piss off Jesus?
They didn't choose this. They didn't desire it.
Right. They were born gay.
No, they weren't born that way. It's because of the insecurity within themselves.
Well, it takes a lot of security to walk out of the house with assless chaps.
They're not happy.
They're called gay.
I know they're...
It took the word. Some of them look positively thrilled.
No, they're people who are really not complete in who they are as men or women.
That's a pretty big judgment for a Christian.
It's not a judgment.
That's not a judgment that you are sitting here telling these people who you don't even know that they're incomplete because they're not like you.
Today, it's not the people you suspect that are gay.
People like the Reverend Ted Haggard.
Moral purity is better than immorality.
Who kept meeting homosexual prostitute in a hotel room and having gay sex with speed.
Evangelicals have the best sex life of any other group. Good morning, Dwayne.
But he wasn't gay.
I already answered that. I don't believe that anybody is gay.
I don't know, but honestly, if I just saw you like in a bar or something, I would say, and don't take this the wrong way, I would say, yeah, I think that guy's gay. You're good looking. You're neat. You know, you don't look like me.
Meaning.
but. All right. Thank you.
Can I come over and give
you
a hug?
Yes.
I hug everybody, so can I give you a hug?
Thanks.
Thank you very much. Hey, you didn't have a heart on there, did you?
No. Sorry. Can't do that. That was good, though.